Hello everyone, welcome back to Chenda DIY. And today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a simple vest. It is really easy if you guys know some basic stitches like single crochet and half double crochet. And now let's get into the video. First, we are going to make the front part of the vest. To begin, make a slip knot. And chain 51. It is equal 14 inches length. It is the measurement of my bust. It measuring from one underarm to another underarm. If you guys want your vest bigger, please add more chains. Remember, your foundation chains must be the odd number. After you reach your desired fit, next, for row 1, we are going to make single crochet. To begin, skip 1 chain and make single crochet into the second chain. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull up a loop. So now you have 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 2 loops. Keep repeating this into every chain until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. Next, for row 2, we are going to make the moss stitch. To begin, chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. After you have made a single crochet, then chain 1, skip 1 stitch, and make single crochet into the next stitch. Keep repeating this by chain 1, skip 1 stitch and make single crochet into the next stitch until you have 1 last stitch, then I will meet you back again. After you had 1 last stitch remain, then we are going to make single crochet into that last stitch. Next, for row 3, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. After you have made single crochet, then chain 1, skip 1 stitch, and make single crochet into the chain 1 space. Keep repeating this by chain 1, skip 1 stitch, and make single crochet into the chain 1 space until you have 1 last stitch, then make single crochet into that last stitch. After you reach the end of the row, for the next row, we are going to repeat row 3 until you reach row 17. It is equal 4.5 inches width. If you guys want your waist longer, please add more rows. And this is what the waist looks like after you reach row 17. Next, we are going to make the crease for both sides. Continue from where your last stitch is for row 18, chain 1. Turn your work. Skip one stitch. And make single crochet into the next stitch. After you have made a single crochet, then make another single crochet into the chain 1 space. So for these 2 single crochet, it is where we are going to make the crease for the next row. Next, chain 1. Skip 1 stitch and make single crochet into the chain 1 space. Keep repeating this into every stitch until you have 3 last stitches, then I will meet you back again. After you had 3 last stitches remain, then make a single crochet into the single crochet stitch. Next, we are going to make single crochet decrease. To make single crochet decrease, insert the hook into the chain 1 space, yarn over and pull up a loop. So now you have 2 loops on your hook. Then continue insert the hook into the last stitch. Yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Next, for row 19, chain 1, turn your work, skip 1 stitch, and make single crochet into the next stitch. After you have made a single crochet, then chain 1, skip 1 stitch, and make single crochet into the chain 1 space. Keep repeating this into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches. Then we are going to make single crochet decrease again. For these 2 stitches, it is where we are going to make decrease for the next row. For the next row, we are going to repeat row 18 and row 19 until you reach row 27. It is equal 10 inches length. It is the measurement of my chest. If you guys want it smaller, please add more decreasing rows. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 27. Next, fold this piece into two pieces and use stitch marker to mark at the middle part of it. For the next part, we are going to make the V-neck. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is for row 28, chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. After you have made a single crochet, then chain 1, skip 1 stitch, and make single crochet into the chain 1 space. Keep repeating this into every stitch until you have 3 last stitches from the stitch marker, then I will meet you back again. After you have 3 last stitches remain, then skip 1 single crochet stitch and make single crochet decrease into the next stitch. Next, for row 29, chain 1, turn your work, skip 1 stitch, and make single crochet into the next stitch. After you have made a single crochet, then make another single crochet into the chain 1 space. Next, chain 1, skip 1 stitch, and make single crochet into the chain 1 space. Keep repeating this into every stitch until you have 1 last stitch, then make single crochet into that last stitch. Next, for row 30, chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. After you have made a single crochet, then chain 1, skip 1 stitch, and make single crochet into the chain 1 space. Keep repeating this into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches, then we are going to make single crochet decrease again. For the next row, we are going to repeat row 29 and row 30 until you reach row 38. It is equal 1.5 inches width. If you guys want your V-neck wider and the strap smaller, please add more decreasing row. Remember, we only decrease only one side. It's where the V-neck line. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 38. Next, we are going to make the strap. Start from row 39 until row 54, chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. After you have made a single crochet, then chain 1, skip 1 stitch, and make single crochet into the chain 1 space until you have 1 last stitch, then make single crochet into that last stitch. So start from row 39, we stop making decreasing stitch. Just make no more rows with the more stitch. If you guys want your strap longer, please add more rows. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to repeat the same thing to the other side. To begin, attach the yarn into the corner part. And chain 1. For row 1, make the mark stitch into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches from the stitch marker. Then we are going to make single crochet decrease. Row 2, chain 1, turn your work, skip 1 stitch, and make single crochet into the next stitch, then start making the mark stitch until you reach the end of the row. For row 3, chain 1, turn your work and make the mark stitch into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches. Then we are going to make single crochet decrease again. Like I said, you always decrease only one side at the V-neck part. It is where we use stitch marker to mark. For the next row, we are going to repeat row 2 and row 3 until you reach row 11. It is the same number like the other side that we made decrease. And start from row 12 until row 27. We stop making decrease and just make no more rows with the mark stitch. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Remember, for both sides must be have the same number of the rows. Next, we are going to make the back part of the vest. It is the same thing like the front side of the vest, just have a little bit different at the neckline. For the back part, we begin with 51 chains and make the mark stitch for 17 rows. After that, we are going to make decreasing stitch for both sides. Start from row 18 until row 27. And start from row 28 until row 50. Just make no more rows with the mark stitch, no decrease. And we still have 4 more rows left. We are going to make the strap. First, count the number of the stitches of your front strap. For my front strap, I have 8 stitches in total. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is. For row 51, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. Then chain 1, skip 1 stitch and make single crochet into the chain 1 space. Keep repeating this until you got 7 stitches. Then we are going to make single crochet into the last stitch. In total, you must have 8 stitches. Keep making the mark stitch until you reach row 54, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. So for the front part of my vest, I have 54 rows in total. So for my back part of the vest, must be have 54 rows the same. Next, we are going to repeat the same thing to the other side by attach the yarn and make the moss stitch for 4 rows. And this is what the back neckline looks like. Next, we are going to connect both sides together. To begin, attach the yarn into both straps. And chain one. Next, we are going to make single crochet both sides together. Keep making single crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. Then chain one and cut off the yarn. Repeat the same thing to the other side. After you have connected everything together, then turn the waist right side out. Next, we are going to make the ribbing panel around the bottom of the waist. To begin, attach the yarn and chain 2. Next, for row 1, make half double crochet into the same stitch with chain 2. To make half double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Keep making half double crochet into every stitch around until you reach the chain 2 stitch. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch. To make slip stitch, continue insert the hook into the chain 2 stitch, yarn over and pull through all the loops. For the next row, we are going to make front post, back post, half double crochet. Start from row 2 until row 6, chain 2, and make half double crochet into the next stitch. After you have made a half double crochet, then we are going to make front post half double crochet. To make front post half double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook behind the half double crochet post. Yarn over and pull through the post, and now you got 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. After you have made a front post half double crochet, then we are going to make back post half double crochet. Yarn over, insert the hook in front of the half double crochet post. Yarn over and pull through the post. And now you got 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And this is how we make front post, back post, half double crochet. Keep repeating this around until you reach the chain 2 stitch. Then we are going to make slip stitch to connect the row. For the next row, we also repeat the same thing like row 2 by chain 2 and make half double crochet, and then make front post and back post half double crochet. After you reach row 6, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to make the ribbing panel around the strap or around the underarm part. We are going to repeat the same thing like we did in the bottom of the vest. To begin, attach the yarn and chain 2. For row 1, we are going to make half double crochet around and then make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch. Next, start from row 2 until row 3, chain 2, and make a half double crochet. Then we are going to make front post, back post, half double crochet around until you reach the end of the row. And we are going to make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch. After you reach row 3, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to make the ribbing panel around the neckline. To begin, attach the yarn into the corner part and make half double crochet into every stitch until you reach the V shape. Then we are going to make half double crochet decrease by make half double crochet 3 together. To make half double crochet 3 together, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Then continue insert the hook into the next loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 4 loops on your hook, and continue insert the hook into the next loop. So now you have 5 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all 5 loops. Next, continue make half double crochet into every stitch around until you reach the corner part, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the corner part of the back neckline, then skip 1 stitch and make half double crochet into the next stitch. Keep making half double crochet into every stitch until you reach the corner part, then we are going to skip 1 stitch. After you skip 1 stitch, then make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch. Next, for row 2 until row 3, chain 2 and make a half double crochet. Then make front post, back post, half double crochet around until you reach the chain 2 stitch. Then we are going to make slip stitch to connect the row. After you reach row 3, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, use darning needle to weave in. And now we are done for the ribbing part. And this is what the vest looks like. For the cherries tutorial, you guys can check the link in the description below. And after you have made the cherries, then we are going to attach the cherry. For this red yarn, we use for sewing the cherries. And for the green yarn, we use for sewing the leaves. And now your simple cherry vest is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.